version today, just for a change of pace. And when we do the grand battements, we're going to do the three, we're going to do one, two, and then three, tap down, lift up, and close. All right. I don't think there were any other changes. You know what? Hold tight. I have to put this volume back up. Oh, it is good. Heels together, toes turned out. Prepare the arm. We're brought to the bar. Releve. And balance. Lower the heels. Demi. Press the heels. Point time do as you come out of that. Port de bras over the leg. Up. Close. Side. And toward the bar. Releve. Hold. Side, keep it controlled to the back. trying those little wraparound things for my shoes that Glenda gave me. Arms high. Second to fourth, pull up, return, pull up, return, and point, and close. Last week, I think we did three of the, we didn't do the tendu at the end, we did three of the passe prep. Do it whichever way is best for you. Okay. Let us begin. This time and less of the chasse. Oh my goodness, it's a good balance workout. Yeah, what you want to think about when you're doing all of this is to keep all your placements correct, not to switch and swivel and fall out to the side and all that. And when you're going from here to here, your hips stay facing front, shoulders front. Don't let it twist and swivel all around. You're going to work that placement very precisely, all right? So you pull up and immediately you're there. So both hips are rolling out at that point, and you're holding that. Hopefully I'll remember to do a particular stretch at the end to deal with tightness here. Okay, let's go on to our quick waltz. One, two, three. One, two, three. Walk around yourself. Two, three, four, five. Plie. Down, up, down, up, down, up. And walk. Two, three, four, five. Left arm up, left arm down. change it every time. Okay. Our stretch. I love this one. I'm facing you for this one. Heels together. Find your comfortable turnout. Lunges, okay? So you're getting down kind of as deep as you can go for you, side, and kind of overcrossing your fourth, okay? Bring a chair in. Let's begin with that stretch I was talking about, to stretch this. Take your, the leg that's toward me, cross it behind. Okay, so you're standing with both feet on the ground, but you've crossed. Now you're going to send your hips back, and your body forward, hold on. And just hold on there, and that gives a little stretch. Come back up, uncross, and now sink. Different kind of stretch. So you're going to bend the leg that's away from the knee and sink into that hip. As long as you're just feeling the stretch, that's fine. If you're feeling pain, don't go that far or don't do it at all. And then the other side, you're going to take that leg, cross it behind, stretch forward with your spine, your hips go back. Probably you're already thinking of the two ballet moves that this resembles, right? Passé and attitude. Speaking of attitude, right? For a second. So you're holding on lightly. Hopefully you're not death gripping your chair. Take your leg, cut it in across and up. And you want to just pay attention to how this feels in your hip. That's a lot of work, back and around. When you get to the front, to the side front, then you go cross down and around, and back. the upright position. Front leg to back. Hips move back, body moves down. And if you're tight in the hamstrings, you'll feel this in the hamstrings. Imagine that. Bend and straighten. And when you come up, you're going to step forward on the foot that's away from me. And return and push forward. Low, long, low reach. Oh, did we forget to do this on the last one? Arms come up, then body comes up. Then high arch. And return. All right, very good. Let's come back now to just step away from your chair. And I'm trying to think which ones I want to do. Let's do, because we've been working on that fourth position placement, heels under hips, toes slightly turned out, bend, and shift. All of you're still upright, you're not tilting, you're just shifted. Lift up that free leg and move it in front. Stretch it out, but don't straighten your knees. Set the heel down, and then go forward and back. So this is like the Tai Chi version of fourth position. Now I have my heels too close together, like this way, so I just separated that a bit. So when you do the rocking, there's almost like a diagonal-ness to it. So this is like, kind of like a modern dance fourth. Now you're gonna shift forward. You want all of your weight on your standing leg, your front leg. Try not to let the hip go out to the side that way. Let's pull yourself up, nice and level. Pick up that back leg. Swing it through like you're walking. Set the heel down. Set the toes down. Push back and forth. Again, I'm too narrow here. I'm going to bring this open. You want to see a little airspace in there. My hips aren't that narrow. I know that. So again, there's that like a diagonalness to this move. As you rock forward, the heel and back goes up. It's pushing you forward. The heel goes down. It pulls you back. Toes come up and you get pushed further back. Remember, your movement is kind of driven by the feet and ankles. And when the feet and ankles aren't doing their job, hips have to take over, backs have to take over, knees have to take over. And that's when you find yourself in a heap of trouble. Now push off that back foot, all of your weight on this front foot. Again, try not to push and sink into that, but keep pulled up nice and tall. Don't lift this one though either, keep level. Then you're just gonna pick this leg up, here you are balancing beautifully, and swing it through. All right, set the heel down, a little wider. Rocking. Shifting. Swinging through. Setting down. Rocking. Pay attention to all the bits and pieces because you've got this toes down, heel up, heel down, toes up. Get your feet and ankles used to doing their job. I feel like I'm in slow motion, like, yeah. Okay, it is time to finish, so thank you for joining me for today's Ballet Fusion, and I'll see you next time, and hopefully we'll be in person soon. God bless you all.